Good evening, lovers. You've caught me in a vulnerable state. Welcome back to another hour of semi-somnambulist monologues and whimpers, interlaced with some musical experiments and probings. Let us reject the cool in favor of the deranged. Let's reject the deranged in favor of the troublesome. My name is Jack King Spooner, but you can call me Glitter Bunting. This week, we're going to weave a pall to smother the sky. The tiger lily has nothing on us, my dears. In the air is a spell for us. Witchcraft, my sisters, is the theme of the day. Here is my desire. I float on a bed of gravity just inches from the ground. Around me, a circle of salt. In my shadow, the floor becomes malleable until it is the viscous consistency of treacle. A pale hand reaches up and punctures my navel. A bliss of hot pain builds at the top of my spine. I bend backwards. My back cracks. Back over back, I fold and slip into the floor. I am in the earth now. It is an earthly desire I crave today. Our guest today is Britney Spears. Britney, tell us of your garden of lost souls.
My garden of lost souls is full of stories. This is a story about a girl named Tender. Here is me asking for help.
Thank you, Britney. Our first song today is called Faint, and is a repetitive, minimalist piece. This song is for every little girl with dreams to become a star.
Thank you.
read your fortune. A 2-card reading between Earth and Fire. The 4 of Fingers is drawn. The Earth element signifies the physical and the tangible. Having a water card here might indicate a friction, and it being a 4 in the suit points to a preparation for a conflict. There seems to be an emotional investment that needs to be sealed with a physical act. The Hanged Man is drawn. Fire is related with sex and is a masculine element linked with drive and willpower. Having the Hanged Man card in this element seems to suggest that one should give in to deviant desires and become open to perverted acts. And so, your fortune. A chance meeting opens new pain. Enjoy the good luck a frown brings you. Death at sea alone is always on the mind of a flying bird. Meeting adversity well is the source of your strength. Yet adversity is the parent of anxiety. It's amazing how much evil you can do if you don't care who gets the credit. You learn nothing from your mistakes. You will learn a lot of nothing today. Today, it's up to you to create the disruption you long for.
Lovers, I'm the spit in the summer breeze.
Are you that kind of love? I'm not. Let me tell you the history of the wand. During the Middle Kingdom of ancient Egypt, magicians would use wands to enable the soul of embalmed corpses to carry over spiritual knowledge to the afterlife. The procedure involved the mystic inserting the thicker, more bulbous end of the wand into his anus and inserting the other, more pointed tip of the wand into the anal cavity of the embalmed. It is thought that reducing the magician to a vulnerable state, combined with the intense sexual awareness, helped channel the passage of the pharaoh's spirit self. One might think that a lot of illness would come from such a practice, but an unforeseen result of this practice was the first extractions of parasitic worms. Wands were used to draw out long-bodied, intermuscular parasitic worms by wrapping them slowly around the wand so as not to break them or allow them to escape back into the body. By gently swiveling the wand in a tight circular motion around the rectum, it was such a successful treatment that it is still used today, and the circular motion has now become an intrinsic part of all spells that entail the use of a wand. It is thought that the two snakes entwined in the staff of Hermes are derived from this parasitic worm treatment. The wand later developed a symbolic quality, that of the serpent. A great many wands have been found emblazoned with the caduceus symbol of two snakes copulating. The caduceus was the wand-like staff of the Olympian god in Greek mythology. The story goes that Tiresias, a blind poet, heard two snakes fucking and, with a sanded branch, bludgeoned the female snake to death. Upon doing so, he immediately turned into a woman until, many years later, Tiresias was able to find the male snake and repeat the sexual act with it to completion. Hermes took the sanded branch and whittled it into the caduceus, believing it to have transformative powers. The wand has been used practically to interrupt the psychic plane, and when used correctly, will not only secure great results, but will also cause the wielder a sensation of pleasure. This next song is called Mating Snakes. Thank you. Have you ever struggled to understand? There is no great plan. The engines that drive us towards our solutions are running on fumes. There is no orchestration. We have been violently shaken, then told to march. Hello, caller. How can I help you?
When I close my eyes, there is no light.
It may surprise you, but this is a common complaint. Do not struggle. Let the memory of light pass away. Hello, caller from the 044 region. How can I help you?
My boyfriend only wants to fuck in the dark. I love him and his body the way it is, and have reassured him that he needn't be ashamed. What do I do?
Dear caller, he hates you. He hates your body, and increasingly, he hates your soul. Love for him is an ordeal. I know his sort. His love is a labor camp in which you have tattooed his neck. Let him slip away and mark his next love with light. Pain and regret are your only allies. This next song is called Dream Wild.
Thank you.
I wear my obscurity as a badge. Enough about me, though. This week's video game review is of Mario. Characters are represented with large heads and short limbs, evoking the proportions of a child. This is indicative of the capitalistic infantilization of culture, designed to lead consumers into believing the product is friendly, on one hand, and to keep them in a childlike stupor with the other. The more capitalist a culture is, the more it wants to be treated like a child. A sub-theme of Mario is the unfettered nature conspiring to steal and fuck the princess, our princess. At the end of Mario, we have the cliched, yet unexpected twist, when our protagonist catches his reflection in a pool of water and sees not the chummy mustached face he expected, but that of Bowser, the libidinous dragon. I would recommend this game to those who are sexually repressed and to 9-year-olds. Otherwise, you are wasting your life in a capitalism-induced mediocrity. I hope, if they choose to make another Mario, Mario 2, shall we say, they add more phallic symbolism to Bowser the Dragon, in addition to his bondage rings, tuft of hair, his spurtings, and his nice meaty tail. They could perhaps add veins. Thank you. And so we draw towards our end. Let me leave you with a spell. A spell is a recipe that best cements an intention so that it might come to fruition. By referencing contemporary media, a witch can tap into a certain collective consciousness. With this particular spell, the witch can bequeath confidence upon a potential sexual partner. This is a spell that uses Katy Perry lyrics. You will need a hammer. You will need a plastic doll. The procedure is as follows. Imagine the essence of a potential partner in the plastic doll. Hold the hammer in your dominant hand and place your non-dominant hand either on your heart or sacral chakra. Recite the Katy Perry lyrics.
I wanna see your peacock. Cock, your peacock, cock, cock, your peacock, cock, cock, your peacock.
With every
cock,
strike the doll with the hammer. Repeat until the essence of the potential partner has been released.
It's not like we're poison.
Good night, lovers. The light is rewinding. We shall be delivered. May the night stay dark, and may our minds stay sharp.
With spit, and my cup overflows.